Even Milton, my favorite. But hail, thou goddess, sage and holy. Hail, divinest Melancholy, whose saintly visage is too bright to fit the sense of human sight. In spite of our differences and the awkward situation, a trust and friendship filled some of the gaps between John and I. Occasionally, it was a struggle to find common interests to discuss. I often found myself playing dumb so John wouldn't feel insecure. Even then, he probably didn't understand half the things I said to him. I loved literature and philosophy, while John was happy with a tall drink and a nice sunset at the end of the day. He was uncomplicated. If ever there was a mismatched couple, it was us. I still wonder, was it the isolation that made him so compelling to me? Looking at him, you wouldn't believe me. But he could actually be very charming and romantic when the mood struck him. There were moments, presents, innocent flirtation, and the times we sat in the dark listening to music were among the best of them. Of course, innocent sentiment can only last for so long between two people in such close contact. Can't remember now which one of us was the first to start talking about sex. We talked about everything that first year, and sex is very much a part of everything. John stopped tolerating Milton and wanted to hear more and more from Miller. Only the juicy parts, he would say. What harm could there be in it? I kept asking myself. After all, I was sealed in this tank. We should have known better. Before we knew what we were doing, it had become a habit. The fatty acids used to transform my body into raw motor nerves ought to have been used on the emotional sector of my brain as well. Here I was, on Venus, falling in love with John George Clay, the bard without a song, the intellectual without the intellect. Unfortunately, I just wasn't real to John. I guess I was like a interactive entertainment system. Equipment that should shut down when he wanted to think of other things. God, am I saying this? John tried to make up for the distance between us. Pictures from his personal library could be mixed with my voice and Miller's words, mix and match, cut and paste, Sports Illustrated, Playboy, and me. New issue, due out in February. Well, it made him happy. So I was happy too. But even thousands of miles away from Earth, human nature prevailed over technology. And our once happy relationship deteriorated. Maybe if I could have fully participated. I'll never know. No more friendship or even conversation, just me servicing his needs. The quiet moments weren't enough for him anymore. When he didn't get what he wanted from me, he became spiteful and abusive. That's when he began to sing that awful song. The combination of that song and his vulgar rendition of Milton's poetry, which at the time was my only solace. I can't begin to tell you how much that hurt. Well, without thinking of his safety, I just began to shut down. To withdraw into my own memory banks. After you recite something enough, it just becomes a part of you. But hail, thou goddess, sage and holy. Hail, divinest melancholy. When John realized what was happening, then and only then, did he try to coax me back. But it was too late. I was gone. That's when he began to fight. Good night, eyes. Good night, ears. Good night, heart. Good night, my love. Honestly, I forgot that without me there would be no oxygen. Hopefully that's all over. I can be repaired and we can get everything back up to speed. Maybe you'd like to hear a poem. How about a bit from Papenzoroso? I just love Milton. These pleasures melancholy give. And I with thee will choose to live. Isn't it beautiful? Hello? Are you still there? Hello?
Sun shines through. Smile, my honey dear, while I kiss away each tear, or else I shall be melancholy too.